after that. Also remember to bring your army to his choke at this point. He's not really attacking or adding pressure to my units, so I can keep them no problem, and that will also allow me to kill every single civvy scout that he might send. It kind of gives me an edge to know when he's moving out and so on. And also notice how I'm attempting on making a triple expansion, which could be kind of risky if he's gonna skip some SCVs to do a timing push. In that case, making a triple expansion would just take a huge amount of my money and a lot of my supply and so on, since I'm gonna have pretty much only probes. But when he first moves out with the timing push, but I thought I would be able to manage either way. Simply because not only am I being able to drive him back and kind of add some extra pressure with my DTs, besides that, I'm also getting a very fast psionic storm, and that psionic storm can really help me drive him back to his base, like at all situations, pretty much when he moves out. Even if he made a timing push with skipping some SCVs to get a even more powerful attack, that psionic storm can really still help me like drive him back and so on. Notice how even though he's kind of laying some siege on my like goon blocking his choke or whatever, it's not necessarily a problem. They will get like one hit, and then I just move my goons slide a bit back, kind of slowing him down and still being able to keep perfect control over the game and knowing when he moves out and where. Attacking his siege tanks in a case like this really wouldn't be worth it, but maybe some DTs which I made earlier could really add some nice pressure and so on. Also, since I was able to make, like I said, I was able to make DTs right away instead of just observers, since I knew he was going to make a fast expansion anyway, so making DTs is fine really. He wouldn't be able to be adding so much vulture pressure at this point of the game anyway, so it's not really a problem. Keep adding gateways. The most important thing about when coming to good macro, in my opinion, at least for me, is that I've noticed that if I just have careless unit, building placement, I will have a very difficult time on actually keeping up good macro, and that really becomes like very essential. If you have good building placement, you can just place one building after another, you can easily produce new units and so on, and it's going to make a massive difference when it comes to macro. For example, compared to very sloppy unit placement, you'll always be wondering where you'll be placing the next building. You'll be kind of like confused on where to build, and you might even have several second delays between every single building, and that might really bring your macro down. This goes for like both Protoss and Terran, every single matchup. Not for Zerg really, since hatcheries are kind of more flexible and you don't really need them as many as gateways and so on. So with Zerg this is not a problem, but whatever. Also notice, since I'm kind of in his choke and I know everything, where he's moving out and when, I'm also able to see when he's harassing and where, and that really makes a massive difference. I can just move my units over there and kind of like protect my expansion with these units. On the other hand, if I just was careless with my stuff and just let him vultures come over here, it would be only now that I react, and I could lose this expansion, I could lose all my probes over there and so on. But right now, since I was able to do it like this, I'm able to kill his vultures without losing almost any probes at all, or anything for that matter, and that really makes a difference, I think. Also notice that I made a pylon block in one of my expansions. It's I really like them, they're very useful, kind of like allows you to buy more time for your main army to come over there while the pylon block is taking the hits from vultures and tanks. And really, I don't really lose anything, I only gain. The secret behind it is that the vultures don't really do any damage to your pylons at all. They take a huge long time to like do anything, and besides that, there's also the factor that that your main army is just able to come over and take care of whatever. And over here, it's pretty obvious that he's gonna try. He's probably having an expansion down there. The way he lays siege, if you can see that he's kind of covering his natural and the bridge. And as we know in Athena, there's a gas expansion down over there, even on a high ground. So it's very valuable for a Terran and easy to defend, kind of. So I'd expect him to have an expansion over there. Also, right now he's kind of driving me back more. I'm still having my army around the map, but not quite as careful with it. I'm also making an arbiter attack. You can make a quick arbiter attack and kind of having small amount of ground army, and you can make like a bit slower arbiter attack, which will be on time if you have a good ground army production and still be very useful and so on. Since I noticed that most of his army is just down over there, kind of protecting these two expansions, I noticed that I have a perfect path on attacking his expansion over here. It was pretty obvious that he had an expansion up, so I brought a group of dragoons, and these will easily take care of this expansion, allowing me to kill most of his SCVs and the command center, and that's really gonna make a difference. Also notice that since he's probably building about like triple expansion then right now, that one gas expansion I'm laying waste on right now, that one mineral only up on that hot raised jungle whatever, and so on. I'm still gonna be needing more expansions. If you can notice, on that upper left hand corner, I already have a probe over there, so I'm able to build up a new expansion. I'm gonna have to try and out expand my opponent if I want to win a Terran over a Terran, since a Protoss is gonna need more expansions than a Terran. I should always try to out expand my opponent, so it's very important that I keep producing stuff. And also remember to keep your army around. For example, if my army was not over there right now blocking path to my expansions and so on, who knows what would happen if a random group of vulture harassed attempt or something attacked and so on. I wouldn't be able to do much at all to stop them, and they could deal far more damage than is simply useful. So it's very useful to keep your army around. This is a very big Nubai mistake. They kind of keep their army in only one spot, and maybe in their natural or something, that's like the worst, instead of actually keeping them in strategical position and so on. For example, right now I'm able to prepare a flank at any moment in a matter of seconds, while still protecting pretty much every single spot, and that really becomes useful. Also notice that since I have a lot of High Templars, these really become useful when I'm storming like the living crap out of his whole army. And this is exactly what I mean. If he did a timing push, my army would be a bit weaker than like his army, but these fast Templars allow me to still survive the attacks, and that's why I was able to take the triple expansion, especially because of that. And it's GG, Arbiter tech coming up and so on. Keep producing units, GG.